Happy Sunday, Birdie Brigade. My people of the Birdie Brigade, Einstein awaits your presence. How is everybody doing? Einstein, can you wave? We're in the kitchen today. And Einstein's been chewing up a silicone steamer, and he's gonna be on the floor playing with his pots and pans. Look at how dented they are. They're already dented. I'll show you later. Hi, cat lover. Are you the only one here? Einstein had his lunch earlier. It's still there, parts of it. He had birdie bread. I see a poop over here. I'm gonna pick up real quick so I don't step in it. Einstein, can you wave? Okay, got it. I got it, Einstein. See, he won't poop on the drawer. He'll come over here and poop off the counter, but he won't poop on the counter or the drawer. Hi, Jane. Yeah, Einstein's agreeing with me. Hi, Diana. Hi, Toucans of Toucans. That's a cute name. Hi, Bread and Circus. Is everybody cold today? It's cold in Texas. We've had a rainy couple of days. Well, one rainy day. All the days have been kind of dreary. Hi, Gloria. I'm using my selfie stick today. Oh, darn it. I'm sorry. Thank you for telling me that. I did that in a hurry. It should be 01. Okay. I can't correct it right now. I'll correct it when I get done here. I messed up on the date last week, too. It must be old age. Hi, Melinda. Einstein didn't growl at the rug that time. That's unusual. Usually when he plays with the rug, he'll start growling. He found a piece of lunch on the floor. Hi, Barbara. No, we have no snow. It's cold, but no snow. Sometimes we do get snow here in Texas. Yes, we did have a good week. Marcia must be getting... Yeah, it still feels like we're in December. Oh, there, Einstein just waved. It feels like we're still in December. I don't know, the days just go by so fast. 4 inches of snow in Kansas. Ugh. Jeff isn't here today. He is out of town. He had to go out of town on some business, some family business. Hello, Sylvia. Einstein's gonna eat his lunch on the floor, it looks like. Einstein, can you wave? Where are you going? Don't hide. Don't hide under there.
What are you seeing under there, huh? What do you see? Why don't you come see me? Why don't you clean up that mess over there that you made? Who's that pretty bird? Who's the pretty bird in the mirror? Sort of a mirror. Can you come see me? 12 inches of snow in Missouri. Ugh. Okay, the question is the groundhog gonna see his shadow? Oh, is Sydney hormonal? Yeah, Einstein's been throwing up a little bit, but not too bad. I should not say throwing up. I should say regurgitating. Oh, you want to come up see me? Come see me. Birds often, if you're not familiar with birds, often regurgitate when they're hormonal. It's a way of feeding their babies. Einstein regurgitates mostly for toys. I'll show you some of the toys that he's been regurgitating on. Oh, Einstein, I don't need you to do that. Come over here. Come over here. Come on, let's show people your toys. Come here. Come here. Oh, that's one over there, that star. Come here, sweetie, up. Come here. You gonna show people the cabinet? There's also another like, where'd it go? Where'd your other, we call him his babies. We don't let him, if he does, it starts doing it too much, we take the toys away from him. I don't know where your other baby is. Oh, I just opened up his drawer and he came running. Come on, up. We'll find it. Einstein, let's make toy soup. This is what we've been doing a lot. Here, let's make toy soup. We'll make toy soup? Not right now? Here, add this to the pot. Add a shoe to the pot. Here, let's make some. He chewed this toy up real big, real good. That was put in his drawer, and he really had a good time with that. I'm going to open up his other drawer. Oh, look what's in there, Einstein. He's been busy in there. This is probably a week's worth. Okay, guys, I'm sorry, I've not been looking at the comments. Oh, hi, Autumn. Hi, Laura. I just noticed you guys. I've been watching what I've been doing. I haven't been able to read the comments. What are you doing? Do you want to make some more soup? Here, let's make some soup. It's good. It's good. Yes, it is. It's so good. What else is back there, huh? Look at all that stuff. No, I did not clean before this broadcast. This is what it is. Oh, you gonna play with that? You gonna drop it? What else are you gonna drop?
You can just see those wheels turning. He's gonna do something here in a minute. Einstein, what are you gonna do now? Okay, let me, I know I told y'all about the dents in the pans. I don't know if y'all can see. I can't really tell. But there's a dent here. You can tell more, I guess, from up here. Yep, they got dents in them. This one too. Oh yeah, this one you can see real good. Look at the, well, anyway, he's been dropping them on the floor. Show, yeah. How do you play with your pots, Einstein? He loves these pots. He mostly likes this lid. Tell that's been dented too. Whoops. You're a good boy, Einstein. What temperature is it in Texas? I would say probably, I haven't looked, but I would say probably the mid 40s, 45 Fahrenheit. Okay, let me transfer the phone to my tripod and we'll see if he wants to talk. Want to fry up anything, Einstein? Wait. Whoops. There you go. Whoops. Okay, let me do a transfer real quick here. Einstein, what you gonna say now? You gonna do some talking? I'll be right back, okay? I'll be right back. You be a good bird. Doing. See you later. You're a good boy. Peek-a-boo. Einstein, you want some broccoli?
Broccoli.
Some corn? Sweet potato. What colors?
Broccoli.
Broccoli, green. been counting.
What's a squirrel?
Can you turn? What are you doing? What's a squirrel? Peekaboo.
What's a squirrel? Where's the money? Einstein, where's the money? You're so funny. I'll see you later. Can you shake? Dancing.
Good boy. Good boy. Where's the mouse? Marcia Mouse. Can you turn around? Marcia.
Where's dancing?
Where's Einstein?
What the birdie?
Go outside. Too cold. laid back today. He's not talking very much. Are you gonna wave at me? Hello, sweetie. Hi, sweetie. Oh, good, they found Lily. I heard that Lily was missing. Gosh, that's one lucky little birdie. Einstein, can you wave? Hi, you're not very talkative today. Yeah, he waved three times, I think. That's what cat lovers said. Okay, now that I'm in the room, he's gonna get into mischief. Did y'all notice the pattern there? He does this just to get... What did he shred? A toy, I guess. Hi, Cindy D. Okay, he's not gonna get into on the ground and get into mischief either. I don't know what he's up to. He's kind of laid back today. I think he misses Jeff. We all miss Jeff, don't we, Einstein? There you go. Einstein, is it cold out? Jeff's out of town right now. He'll be back, oh, probably tomorrow or the next day. He had to go out of town on family business. He's in Michigan, in case anybody is in Michigan on here. Kind of the outside of Detroit. Hi, Janine. No, you didn't miss very much. Einstein's just been talking a little bit, playing with his pots and pans. Birdie yoga. Einstein, yes. Oh, there he goes. He's on the floor. I might have to... Yeah, I know the date of the live stream is wrong. I'll go back and correct that later. I can't do it right now while I'm live. Einstein's thinking he's gonna get the tripod, but he is sadly mistaken. Einstein, no, you're not gonna get the tripod. Let me go get the selfie stick. Where's Einstein? Hang on just a minute. Hang on, sorry guys. Whoop whoop. Whoop whoop. You gonna play on the floor? Okay. Let me get over here and play with these pots and pans. He'll come here. What's that, Einstein? What are you doing? Want to make some soup? Make some wood soup. Make some wood soup. Let me. Here. The drum. You try. There you go. Hi, sweetie. You dancing? What are you doing? Want a close up? Aw, look at the birdie. So pretty. I don't wear contacts, but I buy these contact cases, and he likes to play with them. You can also hide seeds in them and stuff as little treats, little pieces of nuts. And then he unscrews the lid. See, that's one of the lids. And I'll put a nut in there until, of course, he chews it so bad that it's not screwable anymore. But that's one little fun little foraging tool you can make. Einstein, you're just in a weird little mood today. You're not exactly talkative, and you're not exactly rambunctious. That was a spoon that broke, one of my teaspoons, and he now gets to play with the handle part. The spoon part's still around somewhere. I don't know where it is, though. Okay, get back here. I don't know where the spoon part is. It's probably in a bin somewhere. Where are you going now? What was that? He's gonna go check out his little hole in the next to the refrigerator. What you gonna do? There's this little area where my refrigerator isn't quite wide enough, and so I put an egg carton there to keep him out. And he'll chew the egg carton, but he can't get back in there. These are the things you have to do when you own a parrot. For those of you, I know some of you already know this, but I'm just saying this for people who have never watched my stream before, maybe new to my channel. Parrots just change your life in some of the most unique ways. You have to think of everything to keep them out of trouble. Okay, Einstein, come on back here. Come here this way. This way. Oh yeah, parrot proofing is much more challenging than child proofing. A child grows up eventually, and you can reason with them, and you can tell them not to get into things, and they understand the word no. With parrots, sometimes when you say no, it gives them the attention that they want. So Einstein knows the meaning of no. He knows he's not supposed to, but yet he still does it just to get the attention. Yeah, you do, don't you? Shake it. Shake it, Einstein. Shake it. Ooh, yeah, shake it. Is it okay if you choose a foam egg carton? No, I wouldn't. Mostly because of the static electricity. I don't know where you are, but here in Texas, we have real dry days. And a lot of things like that have static, you know, they get real staticky and they'll cling to his beak. I'm just afraid it might cling to his tongue or to his beak, and he won't be able to get, you know, remove it easily. I'd really stay away from things like that. Peek-a-boo, Einstein. What are you doing? Here he comes. Einstein. Is he tired? No, I don't think so. We both got a good night's sleep last night. I just think he's out of sorts. You know, sometimes we have days when we're out of sorts. He's just kind of in a mellow mood. He has different moods day to day. Some days he's just real comical and everything. Other days, not so much. And hey, if you're a Birdie Brigade member, which means you're a subscriber to this channel, hit the thumbs up button for me. Let's see how many of you are out there. And if you're not a subscriber, please subscribe. We do these live streams every Sunday at 2:00 Central Time. And we never know what Einstein's gonna do. Each live stream is completely different because it's live. Come on out of there, Einstein. Come on, let's get a nut. You want a nut? And he hasn't said the C word, cookie. Oh, but he knows I'm getting a nut. Look here. I opened the pantry. You want a nut? Here you go. Want a nut? It's good. That's a treat for no reason. That's good nut, isn't it? Oh, look who's on here. There's Jeff Court. Here's Jeff. Good to see you, Jeff. Einstein. It's Jeff. Peek-a-boo, can you turn around? Peek-a-boo. Einstein, can you wave? There you go. Yeah, his dad, Einstein misses him, that's for sure. Einstein, do you know Jeff is on here? Can you say hi to Jeff? Where's Jeffrey? Where's Jeffrey? Come here, sweetie. Up. Oh, good boy. Good boy. Want give Jeff a kiss. Give Jeff a kiss. Yep, he just kissed my pop socket. Okay. This will be interesting. Einstein, get down. Here, I'll get you another nut. Oh, dear. Hang on. Einstein, no. He's got hold of my pop socket. Come here. Here, I'll get you a nut. I can't find a nut. Here it is. Oh, you ended. Einstein, no. Now he's got the phone. No, don't do that. Get down. Here's a nut. There's a nut. I shouldn't have given him a nut for doing that, but. Yeah, I shouldn't have given him a nut for doing that, but sometimes you have to give him a nut to get him off of things like that. I mean, this was going nowhere with him being on that pop socket on the back of my phone. So I had to find something to distract him. The only way that Kathy can comment is to get on YouTube, on her YouTube channel, and comment. And I believe in order to do that, she doesn't, I don't think, has to subscribe. I'm not sure. But she needs to be logged into YouTube. And then go to my channel, or Einstein's channel, and join the stream. Does Einstein recognize his voice on the phone? Yeah, he seems to. When Jeff calls, I put it on speaker, and he recognizes Einstein. I mean, he recognizes Jeff's voice. If I had another phone, we'd do that. Now what, Einstein? What are you gonna do now? He was eating a piece of cardboard from the PCM. Yeah, he's got very tiny feathers, very, very, very tiny. Eyelashes. Oh, went to the ice festival in Plymouth. I bet that was fun. Jeff is in near Plymouth, Michigan right now, everybody. He's taking care of some family things. Peek-a-boo. 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 I'm asking for it now. Peek-a-boo. Peek-a-boo. See his eyes pinning? That means when they go from real big to small, that means he's likely to bite or lash out or bite the phone. How does Einstein do when visitors come over? Well, he's quiet because he's not sure if they're here to harm him or not. Not that anybody ever has harmed him, but it's instinctive that with African Greys that they just get real quiet. Okay, you wanna get back over here in your drawer? Here, up. I'll give you a ride. Well, get down now. Okay, he's not biting me. He's just giving me a little touch with his beak. Come here. No? What do you want now? Now you have me. Here, look here. Here. Yeah, play with your toys. Okay, Einstein. Whoop. I bent over to get the pot. He almost got the phone again, didn't you? No, he's not very heavy. Einstein weighs 450 grams, which is just about a pound. So he's not very heavy at all. Okay, baby, what's next? What's next for you, huh? Has Einstein ever put shapes in a puzzle? We've tried that, but we didn't get very far. In fact, this is a puzzle piece from one of those little baby games, you know, where you, actually the tub is in the bathroom. That's what we keep his toys in the bathroom is the other little part of this. That, you know, but we didn't keep up with it and he didn't seem to have any interest in it, so we didn't push it. Now he regurgitates for the little parts. Is his beak strong? Yes, it's very strong. And it can inflict major wounds. We've been bitten, both Jeff and I have been bitten several times to the point where it breaks the skin and there's blood. If you ever had a parrot, you'll get bitten. It's just a matter of time. It's not because they're mean. It's a defensive mechanism and it's their way of defending themselves when they're not, when they feel threatened. Or unsure about things. Sometimes Einstein will bite me when he just gets scared, when he sees something that out the window that scares him. Thank you, Jane. That's a nice compliment and observation. I appreciate that. They do require a lot of time and attention. Yeah, cats are pretty easy.
down on the floor again. Well, one of the reasons I'll get bit or Jeff will get bit is because we're just not paying attention. We'll be doing something that, and we're not watching Einstein. And like, if I were to go over to his drawer, I have to watch him because he's real guarded of his drawer. And if I start playing with something that he decides he doesn't want me playing with, he'll run over and he'll bite me. So you just have to keep your eye out. Peek-a-boo. That's right, Melinda. They're very smart, and they are a commitment. Einstein, where are you going? Yes, Einstein will do that too. He'll give me a little nip. It's just a warning nip. Einstein hasn't bitten me in a long time, to be honest, but it can happen. That beak was designed for a reason. And like I have a t-shirt that I made. It's on Amazon. I think it's on Redbubble too, but it says something like a parrot is a 2-year-old with a can opener on its face. And it's true. It's a can opener. Yeah, I design t-shirts for parrot rescue organizations. And you can find them. There's a link below to a Redbubble store and to my Amazon store. So you can go there and check them all out. Okay, you guys. I think we're gonna say goodbye. Einstein, can you wave? Thank you all for joining us. I'm sorry. Well, I'm not sorry, but Einstein just wasn't as talkative as normal or as active. Just kind of laid back and just kind of chilling on a chilly day. Oh, you're wearing the high four shirt. Great, thank you. Thank you for getting that. That's one of my favorites. I have one too. Yeah, I've been on YouTube a long time. 12, yeah, has it been 12 years? I think, yeah, I got on 07, I think. You're wearing the Birdie Brigade shirt. Yay, I am too. I am too. Let me show you. Whoop, there you go, Birdie Brigade. Okay, you guys, you have a great week. I know it's very late in some parts of the world for some of you. Thanks for tuning in. We love having you. And we'll see y'all next week, okay? Okay, bye-bye. Can you wave, Einstein? Hey, bye-bye. Bye-bye, sweetie.